Alexa, loop mode on. Jesus, we bless you, we bless you, we bless you this morning. Hallelujah. Good morning, hallelujah. Manda no sota namaseke. Where you are, just worship. Let's just worship. Hallelujah. We made it to the end of a work week, but it is not the end of the work of the Lord. Hallelujah. So we are in expectation of what the Lord is doing and saying and bringing to us, hallelujah, and what he's allowing us to realize. I believe that the realization of the demonstration of the Father is at your side this morning. The realization of the demonstration of the Father is with you this morning. The realization of the demonstration of the King of Glory. So we just worship. We worship this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for the demonstration, the suddenlies, the self-same hour, the word of the Lord, the ways of the Lord. Hallelujah. Is with you this morning in the name of Jesus. And so God, we just worship. We worship, we worship, we worship. Hallelujah. We acknowledge you, King of Glory. We acknowledge you. We acknowledge your presence. We acknowledge your word. We acknowledge you this morning. We acknowledge you. Hallelujah. Manda so Rebecca. There's a lot of people who wake up this morning and they won't acknowledge you. They wake up this morning, they do their life and they won't acknowledge you. Hallelujah. But it's because of the Holy Spirit that we're in a place where we acknowledge your presence. We acknowledge you. We acknowledge that you are speaking. We acknowledge that you are speaking. Hallelujah. So we worship. Hallelujah. Glory to you. Glory to God forever. Yes, 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 forever. Forever. Forever, forever, forever. Come on, guys. Where you are, let's just worship. Hallelujah. Forever. I remember a day when I didn't worship. I remember a day when I couldn't worship. I remember a day when I didn't know the value of worship. I didn't understand the presence of God, and I didn't understand the transforming power of the presence of God in worship alone. Mandio soto ramasi, where the presence of the Lord is, there is the transforming grace. Where the presence of the Lord is, there is the grace to transform. There is the grace to transition. There is the grace, manda rokotama, to be translated. Where the presence of the Lord is. Hallelujah. And so this morning, we just worship. Come on, where you are, let's worship. Glory to God. We worship, we worship, we worship. Mandio sanda rakanda moso rebeki. We worship, we worship, we worship, we worship you, Jesus. We worship you, King of Glory. We worship you, Mighty One. We worship you, soon to come. We worship mountain moving God, mountain creating God. The earth is yours, the fullness thereof, the world and those that dwell therein. We worship you. Every seat in the earth belongs to you. Every seat in the celestial belongs to you. Everything belongs to you and is yours. And so we just bow before you this morning. And we bow this prayer wall before you this morning. We believe that this is a place of signs, wonders and miracles. Hallelujah. So we just worship. We worship this morning. We worship this morning. Manda, so we are people of worship. We believe in the value of worship. We understand that you receive our worship. Manda sokote, because it's in worship that we take our eyes off of ourselves. We put our eyes on you. Hallelujah. And what shouldn't be on us, what doesn't look like you, it begins to be amplified. And that's when we can begin to walk away from it. That's when we can begin to say, oh God, I'm sorry for that. Oh God, forgive me for that. Oh God, help me move beyond this. Help me to lay this aside. Help me to walk away from this. And so this morning, God, it is in worship that repentance begins to rest upon us. It is in worship, God, when we behold your glory, that we begin to notice things about us and in us that doesn't just kind of measure up.
up. It's not under condemnation, it's under correction. And so we thank you that in your presence there is the grace to be corrected. And we receive the grace this morning in the name and in the blood of Jesus. And so we bring this whole week before you. We bring the whole month before you. And we say to you, King of Glory, what we have done that does not represent you wholly and fully in us, what does it represent where we're supposed to be and how we're supposed to be tracking with you in this season. We ask for forgiveness in the name of Jesus. And so we worship. We worship. We acknowledge you, God, in every facet of our lives. We acknowledge you, God, in every crack and crevice of our lives. We acknowledge you, God, in every part of our person. We acknowledge you in the name of Jesus. Where you are, guys, just worship. Type in your worship. Just type it in. My soul, it's all of us. It's all of us. We believe in the corporate anointing. Hallelujah. We believe in the corporate anointing. We believe in corporate faith. And so we get up at 6 a.m. and we come together not to hear somebody pray, but we come together so that we can join our prayers. We believe that there is power in numbers. We believe there is power in numbers. And he's given to all of us a measure of faith. Masoto. And so in faith this morning, we join faith with one accord. We worship one God. We call upon one Savior, one Savior, one Savior out of one unction, and we believe that the probability of the manifestation is in our favor. Come on, the probability of the manifestation of the things of God are in your favor. Hallelujah. This morning, I am believing God that what you were supposed to come into your hand, I'm believing God that was supposed to come upon your body. I'm believing God, hallelujah, that what God had tailored for you this week is coming upon you this morning in the name of Jesus. I believe that we serve a God who's not bound by any time. I believe we serve a God who is not bound, masote, by the constraints and the limitations of our humanness. I believe we serve a God that time and distance is nothing for him. And so where we move from Monday, masokote, randa mashataya namoso, what was supposed to rest and sit on us on Monday, what was supposed to, maybe something we skipped over. Hallelujah. Maybe it was something we passed over. Maybe it was something that we didn't understand, that there is still a chance. There is still this promise that is still here. And so this morning we pray into the promises. Come on. We pray into the promises. We pray into the promises, not just for us individually, but we pray into the promises for the prayer wall. We pray into the promises for the nations. We pray into the promises for the people. We pray into the promises for the government. We pray into the promises for the weather. We pray into the promises for creation. We pray into the promises this morning in the name and in the blood of Jesus. Everything that this week was supposed to hold and we were supposed to behold in this week. There's some one thing we're supposed to behold and another thing we are supposed to hold. Sometimes we're just supposed to look at some things and other times we're supposed to handle some things. And so everything that we were to behold, Psalms 91 says that we'll behold some things and it won't come nigh us. And so, Father, in the name of Jesus, we're beholding your glory crushed the enemy. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It doesn't matter what it sounds like. It doesn't matter what it tastes like. In the realm of the earth, we are beholding the arm of God crush, annihilate, the plan of the evil one, the plan of the enemy. We're watching. We're beholding our God. Send his word. We are watching our God. Come on, guys. Send his word. We're watching our God. Send his word and stir himself on the throne. We're watching. We're beholding the glory of God. We're beholding the glory of God. We're beholding the glory of his word. We're beholding every day that we wake up. My God, mesotaya, it means that there is still yet glory to behold. There is still yet promises to behold. There is still yet promises to hold. There is still yet protection in our favor. There is still the favor of God that is still for us every time we open our eyes. And so this week for 5 days, 6 days, whatever, we've opened our eyes. And so, Father, we don't want to skip over, move beyond, or move past, God, anything that you're doing, anything, God, that you have already given us. Thank you, Father, that there were some things that the enemy wanted us to hold. Thank you, Father, that there are some things that the enemy wanted to put upon us this morning. Hallelujah. In prayer, I thank you, Father, that you said that you were chasing away cancer cells. And so this this morning, we pray openly and we pray publicly for the people of God corporately, that where cancer is trying to take hold and grip, where cancer cells are inside of people's bodies and we don't know anything about it. Thank you, Father, that this will be something that does not touch us. And so this morning, we worship. We don't pray against. We don't pray and say, oh, keep us and protect us. We don't do that. We lift our hands in your presence and we say, thank you, Father, for divine health. Thank you, Father, that the cells of the word of the Lord. Remember, the Bible says that the word is living. 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 So if the word is living, that means it's living in us. Come on. The Bible says that he is in us. And so if the word is in us, remember, the word became flesh and it dwelt among men. But we also have the word in us and it's dwelling in man. It's dwelling in our man. And so the word that is in us, that dwells in us, it chases away, it eradicates, it nullifies. Come on. It equalizes. And so that's why this morning we can lift our hands and we can proclaim and claim. We can proclaim and claim. We can preach to our bodies. We can preach and proclaim. We can preach and we can prophesy. We can preach and we can say. We can see and we can say. And we can see that the person of Jesus. We can see that the person of the Holy Spirit. We can see that the person of the Word. We can see that the blood, come on, is on, is in our inward parts. It is in our inward man. And we are being renewed day by day, that the same power that raised Christ, it is quickening or making alive our mortal body. And so that's why we can point our finger at our body and prophesy, be ye quickened according to the pattern of God, be ye quickened according to the mind of God, be ye quickened according to the finger of God, be ye quickened according to the word of the Lord, be ye quickened. Be ye made alive where you are. I need you to put your hand on your chest. I need you to put your hand on your stomach. I need you to put your hand, come on your arms. I need you to put your hand on your head. And I need you to say, be ye quickened per the word of the Lord. Be ye quickened per the proclamation of God. Hunda Mosiah. In history, there's something called the Emancipation Proclamation. Come on. And that's known as the documentation that Abraham Lincoln signed and put into order so that slavery would be done away with. Will we decree and declare that there is an emancipation proclamation in the realm of the spirit, and it is documentation that any strong man, anything that would try to bind, anything that would try to put our members in slavery, anything that would try to put our mind in slavery, anything that would try to put our purpose in slavery, anything that would try to put our potential in slavery, that we have been emancipated according to the scripture, John 10:10, I came that you may have life and have it more abundantly. Whom the Son has set free is free indeed. Emancipation proclamation from Genesis chapter 3 all the way to the last book of the last chapter and the last words of Revelation. It is the redemptive plan of God and it is the emancipation proclamation. And so this morning, we put our hands on ourselves as a point of contact, and every person that is connected to us, come on guys, in terms of assignment, we decree emancipation proclamation. We decree that the freeing power of Jesus Christ is in their lives. Decree the freeing power upon your children and their future seats. Emancipation proclamation upon where your children shall go. Emancipation proclamation for all the things that your children will handle in their future days, in the name and in the blood of Jesus. And so this morning, in the presence of Almighty God, we lift our hands and we bless you, Jesus, for the documentation that has been sent towards us in the realm of the earth that makes us free and keeps us free. It is a trick and the plan of the enemy for us to believe that even when we're going through process, that we are bound by the process. We decree and declare this morning that the process is part of the emancipation proclamation that is inside a process that the Father is teaching us, and he is bringing us to the place where we will begin to build, where we will begin to, where we have been sent to. We are the sent ones. And so while he is sending us, he is also teaching us. And so we say to every process that we are in, every process that the nations are in, every process that creation, come on guys and prophesy, every process that creation is in, every process that every mountain in the earth is in, Every process, come on, that the economies are in, that it's still free. We free, we free, we free. Handamokota mandiose by the proclamation of the word of the Lord. Sometimes, guys, we're still praying, but let's do a little teaching moment. Sometimes in prayer, we direct the word of the Lord to the Lord. And that in prayer, God is directing his word to us. And then we take the word as intercessors and magistrates. We begin to legislate. What does that look like? It looks like you standing flat-footed in your living room and pointing your prophetic finger to the north, the south, the east, and the west, and decreeing the word of the Lord. You saying, hear ye, the affirmation of Jehovah. Hear ye, the declaration of Jehovah. Hear ye, the word of Adonai that stabilizes handamokote, everything that should be working in the realm of the earth in this dispensation of time. Hear ye, the harvest men have come by way of the angelic host of heaven, and they beat back and they fight back and they overturn according to the word of the Lord and the pattern of God. Where you are, I need you to stand up flat-footed in your room, flat-footed in your prayer closet, flat-footed in your living room, flat-footed in your kitchen, and I need you to begin to prophesy. Come on. I need you to begin to proclaim the word of the Lord. This is the second part or the third part or the tenth part to prayer. After the Father has released the word of the Lord, it is then up to us as voice boxes for heaven. Come on, speaking spirits. Come on, speaking spirits who have the responsibility of being human in this dispensation of time. Open your mouth, move your tongue, the tongue of the ready writer, and begin to rewrite history of today. You have to understand, come on, that the enemy has something that he's trying to write on the airways of today. There's something he's trying to write in the historical writings of today. But there is a governmental system called the kingdom of heaven. There is a governmental system called the magistrates of God. And when they come with one accord, and they stand flat-footed and understand, I don't come in my own unction, and I don't come in my own anointing, and I don't come in my own power, and I don't come in my own grace, I don't come in my own glory, but I come in the name of Jesus. Come on. I come in the name of Jesus. I stand under the name of Jesus. And now I point my prophetic finger to the north, the south, the east, and the west. And I proclaim that God has said healing to the nations. I proclaim that God has said healing to the borders. I proclaim that God has said healing to the waters. I proclaim that God has said, come on, healing to the airways. We proclaim Handa Moshe, the name of Jesus, to the directions. We proclaim the name of Jesus, longitude and latitude. We proclaim the name of Jesus upon the mountains. We proclaim the word of the Lord in the mountains. We proclaim. Come on, guys. We release the word of the Lord this morning. We release the sound of heaven this morning. We release the trumpets of heaven this morning. We release the sound of healing this morning. We can stand flat-footed in our living room and point to the north, the south, the east, and the west. We can send forth the sound of healing to every hospital. We can send, come on, the sound of healing to every emergency room. We can proclaim preservation of life upon this 24-hour cycle. Come on, speaking spirits, begin to proclaim preservation of life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And so we do this covered in the name of Jesus. We do this covered in the blood of Jesus. We do this covered, come on, under the mantle of God. We stand in the middle smack dab of the will of God. And we do what we were created to do. Release heaven, 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 Release heaven. Release heaven in your zip code. Come on. Release heaven in your subdivision. Handa tokotaya. Runda mosheka. Runda mashaya. Rikonde besha. In the name of Jesus. And so this morning, God, we bless you. We bless you. We bless you. As we point the finger, Mandioko, representative of the finger of God at the nations. As we point the finger of God at the mountains. Hallelujah. And we decree and declare your heartbeat. Oh, thank you, God, that your heartbeat is in our mouths. Oh, thank you, God, that your heartbeat is in our bellies. Oh, thank you, God, that your heartbeat is in our throat boxes. Thank you, God, that your heartbeat is in our hands. When we clap our hands, we are releasing the heartbeat of God in prayer. When we stomp our feet, we're releasing the heartbeat of God in prayer. When we go forth, we're releasing the heartbeat of God. Come on, guys. Ekonda mashata, randa bokosa, randa masikete beshe. Hallelujah. Rataba, saw something really interesting yesterday. Let me find it. Ekosata randa mosoko rete. Verse 4. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 4. Hallelujah. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 4. We know that this is, you know, the king, Isaiah died. I saw the Lord high and lifted up. Okay. So when you go, I'll start at verse 3. It says, and one cried unto another. One cried unto another and said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts, and the whole earth is full of his glory. Verse 4. And the posts of the door moved. The door of the posts of the door moved at the voice of him that cried. Manda, go back to verse 3. And one cried unto another and said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts, and the whole earth is full of his glory. And the posts of the door moved. And the post of the door moved at the voice of him that cried. We talk about all the time, and the house was filled with smoke. But let's deal with the posts of the door moving at the sound of the voice of him that cried. Cried what? Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts, and the whole earth is full of his glory. And so we, in like fashion, proclaim the same thing along with. We understand that Isaiah was able to see in a realm, and he detailed for us what he was able to see at that moment. Just because we can't see it doesn't mean it's not happening. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts, and the whole earth is full of his glory. And the posts of the door moved, what? At the voice of him that cried. The post of the door moved at the sound of him that cried. And the post of the door moved at the sound of him who cried. And the post of the door moved at the sound of him who cried. Come on, guys. And the post of the doors moved at the sound of the one who cried, at the sound of the one who prays, at the sound of the one who made the sound. And the post of the doors moved. Come on, speaking spirits. Come on, speaking spirits, and cry aloud. Come on, speaking spirits. We have to understand that they're showing us a picture in the realm of the spirit. And the post of the doors moved, my God. And the post of the doors moved. And the post of the doors moved. The boundaries of the doors, the boundaries of the openings, the boundaries were moved at the sound of the crying out. The boundaries were moved. The doors were moved at the sound of the ones crying out, holy, 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 holy. Mandio konda mashe. Holy, 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 holy. We didn't get up to play this morning. We got up to move some things with the sound of praise. We got up this morning to move some things in the sound of worship. Holy, holy, holy. Can you imagine what is moving in the realm of the Spirit? Do you understand that boundaries and limitations are being removed at Kondama Shandioko Nende Ashaya as we proclaim holy, 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 holy. And the Bible says that the post to the doors moved. Come on, guys. At the voice of him that cried, and the house, and the house, and the house was filled with smoke. Masanda roba setea moshia. We understand that there are so many different sides of prayer. We understand, God, that you're accomplishing more than what we understand in prayer. And so, Father, if you would allow us to see in the realm of the Spirit, to see what happens when we praise in prayer, when we worship in prayer. Oh, God, what happens when we stand in the realm of the earth and we lift up a cry as we proclaim the name, as we proclaim the blood. In the name of Jesus, anda sokota, randa mokote. And so we decree and declare, come on, guys, that this day is filled with the glory of God. This 24-hour cycle is filled with the glory of God. This 24-hour cycle, we believe that the glory of God is being released. We believe that the smoke of the presence of God is filling, come on, the doorways, the openings, and the portals in the realm of the earth. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, 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 holy. You understand that when the Bible says that he inhabits the praises of his people, he inhabits the praises of his people, that there are some things I don't need to petition if I would just begin to praise, because his presence would begin to inhabit. And where the presence of God is, there is liberty. And so sometimes we begin to pray and we begin to petition and we begin to plead and we begin to beg, come on, for liberty to come, not knowing and not understanding that if we would just lift our hands and release a sound of praise, that he inhabits. That he abides in the presence of praise. Come on, guys. And where the presence of the Lord is, there is liberty. There is liberty. There is liberty. And so when you're in your car, you're like, oh, God, release me from these people and release me from this place. And when I go here, it feels like this. And I bind this and I bind that. And I bind such and such. And I bind such and such. And we don't understand it. All we got to do is release a hallelujah and raise. Praise the Lord and say holy, 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 because he inhabits the praises of his people. He inhabits the praises of his people. He inhabits the praises of his people. Could that be why? Come on, guys. Greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. And so he inhabits the praises of his people. And so he's saying, if you would release me in you, if you would go out into the world and you would step over the threshold of such and such door, and instead of saying, oh, I bind this and this, you say, I release a hallelujah, I release a bless the Lord, I release the name of Jesus, I release the glory to God, I release it to you, oh King. Could you imagine? Because we understand, come on, guys, that he is inhabiting the praise, that the glory of the Lord wants to shift in the place that you're trying to bind such and thus. The glory of God desires to rest in the place that you're trying to bind this strong man and that strong man. God is saying, is not my presence greater than every strong man put together in agreement? Is not my presence, says the Lord, greater than every strong man ever come into agreement? Every strong man is not in comparison, is not strong enough than the little power in his pinky finger. And so God is saying, what would happen if suddenly you trying to bind such and thus everywhere you go? What would happen if everywhere you went, you release the sound of praise, you release the sound of worship, you sang unto me a new song? What would happen? What would happen? And so this morning we do this. We release the sound of praise, worship, because we understand that's an automatic victory. Come on, guys. It's an automatic victory. Your hallelujah brings an automatic victory. Your hallelujah brings an automatic shift in the earth. Your hallelujah brings an automatic win, not because of us, but because champion God, Lord of hosts, God of the angel armies, he inhabits, he dwells, he sits, and he rests himself in the midst of the praises of his people. And so we bless the name of God this morning. Come on, guys. We bless the name of God this morning for the zip codes. We bless the name of God this morning for the mountains. We bless the name of God this morning for Puerto Rico. We bless the name of God this morning for Australia. We bless the name of God this morning for Russia. We bless the name of God this morning for Iran. We bless the name of God. We say, God, you are a great God. God, you are a great King. God, you are awesome and amazing. And so we understand that when we lift our voices this morning together in harmony and agreement, that God is resting in the midst of our praise. We understand. Come on, guys. Automatic victory is coming to Puerto Rico. Come on. Hallelujah. We know that God loves the people there. We understand that God loves the ground there. We understand this creation belongs to him. And so instead of standing there and binding such and thus and binding that strong man and this strong man, what would happen if everybody just began to bless God for Puerto Rico? We begin to bless God for his hand there. We begin to bless God for revival there. We begin to bless God for reformation there. We begin to bless God for putting his blood there. We begin to bless Jesus for his presence there. We begin to join our prayers and our praise with the inhabitants of the island. We begin to stir the ground. We begin to stir the atmosphere. We begin to stir the atmosphere with praise. We begin to stir the atmosphere with praise. We say victory, victory belongeth to the people. Victory, victory belongeth to the people. Victory, victory belongeth to the people because Jesus is there. Come on. Jesus is there. And so this morning we praise. This morning we praise. This morning we wield our weapon of praise. Akota runda mo sheke runda masandio koshe runda masaya. And so I'm hearing the Lord say, my God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm hearing the Lord say that there are some people on here and you feel like that there's something going on and you feel like some prayers are not getting through. I don't like that terminology, but for whatever reason, you feel like your praying is not moving anything, nothing's shifting by what you're praying. And God says, apply this principle. Apply this principle. Kandioshe, take your eyes off of you. Take your eyes off of what you perceive as an inadequacy and put your eyes on me. My character is unbroken. My integrity is unbroken. My power is unbroken. My word is unbroken. And so when you look at yourself, you see the brokenness of your life. You see the brokenness of your character. You see the brokenness of the places you've been. And the Father says that praise, listen, praise forces you to put your eye upon me. It forces you. That is a weapon of your warfare, because the enemy comes for you to put your eye on you, and he will amplify everything that's wrong with you, and he will accuse you to you. But listen, even in the accusation that the enemy brings against me, the railings that the enemy brings against me, when I begin to praise and repent, matoko randa mashaya, I begin to understand and sit under, and I begin to commune. Come on, I commune with the power of the presence of God, the power of the presence of God, the power of the presence of Jesus, the power of the presence. And so the Father is saying, switch off your petition to praise. Begin to praise me in your prayer closet. Praise me in your car. Praise me over those bills. Praise me over those situations. Praise me over that job. Praise me, praise me, praise me. And what you're going to see is a liberty, liberty, liberty come to those situations, says God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And so this morning we decree and declare upon this prayer wall that there is a sound of prayer. And where the people are being fought back, where the people are trying to be intimidated to close their mouths and not release the sound of prayer, we release the sound of praise on behalf of every person who is in their feel like their back is up against the wall. We decree and declare that there is liberty behind this prayer wall. There is liberty upon this prayer wall. There is liberty in this group in the name of Jesus. And for the people who are not even awake yet, they went to bed and there was a tension, there was anxiety and angst, there was worry and fear that was trying to come through their front door, back door, side door, and every window. We decree and declare through praise, hallelujah, that angels with victory in their hands, angels with victory, come on, in their pockets, are standing at the front door, and these enemies are fleeing before the presence of God seven ways. We decree and declare that behind this prayer wall this morning, people are waking up, and they are waking up in the liberty and the freedom, because some intercessors said, I'm going to get up and I'm going to praise God for you. I'm going to get up and I'm going to release victory for you. I'm going to get up and release a sound for you in the name of Jesus. And so, Ratandio Kote, Randamas Shandio Kosa, Mikote. The Father says, release victory upon your body. I'm hearing the Lord say that there are some people, even for the replay, there are some people you are getting some tests back, or you're waiting on some reports. Andioshe, you're waiting on some reports. Ikotaya, Randamaso, even the baby. I don't know if Angela's even on here, but there's somebody on her job. There's an issue with a baby. We begin to lift a praise for this baby that is in the womb. This baby that is in the womb, we declare victory is in the embryo sac and the amnio fluid. Victory is the amnio fluid. Come on, the word of the Lord concerning this baby, this destiny of this baby, in the name of Jesus, we decree victory, victory, victory for the life of this baby. We decree victory for the birthing of this baby in the name of Jesus. We believe, I'm seeing the I'm seeing like a chart. I see a chart and I see the report, and I literally hear and see God saying wiped away. It is like a wind has come. It's like a wind has come, and I see the words not just being like erased, but I see the words flying off the page. I see the words flying off the page. And so Father, in the name and in the blood of Jesus, we pray into this vision, not just for the baby, but for every single Mandio Kota. I believe in the miracle working power of God. I believe in the miracle power of the word. I believe in the miracle power of the hand of God. I believe in the miracle power of the name of Jesus. I believe in the miracle power of the blood of Jesus. I believe, oh God, and that's why I praise into your power to bring miracles, signs, wonders, and healing to your children. There is nothing too big. There's nothing too small. Your name is Creator God, and so you create everything that we see. And there are so many things that we see and we don't see because we don't understand. The eyes of our understanding in certain things have not been opened up. Just because we don't understand it does not mean it is not resting, does not mean it is not available. And so we pray past our intellect and to the availability, come on, of the miracles, God, that you afford us in the name of Jesus. Mandako randama saya rukundama shata nikondioso rikandama sekai rutunama. I believe in miracles. If you believe in miracles, type it in. We're wielding our weapons of warfare. We're wielding our weapons of warfare. And one of our greatest weapons of warfare is simple belief. I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe the love of God is with that child. I believe that there were angels that had climbed into that sack, Mokonde, with that baby, and they're singing the song of deliverance up to that baby. I believe, Mandal called, that angels have crawled into that sack with that baby, and they are talking to that baby, and they are singing to that baby in the name of Jesus. I believe that every incorrect thing, every incorrect measure, it is being corrected in the name of Jesus. And so it is with you, and so it is with your house, and so it is with every assignment. I believe. Remember, the enemy wants us to begin to doubt God. He wants us to doubt God. I refuse. I refuse. I refuse. I refuse to doubt God. I refuse to doubt the name of Jesus. I refuse to doubt the blood of Jesus. I refuse. I stand flat-footed in belief, and I say, come on, King of glory. Come on, Lord of hosts. Who is the King of glory? You are the King of glory. I believe you fight and win every battle. I call you champion God. Come on, guys. I believe you are the champion of champions. I believe you're the stronger man. I believe you kick over, run over, pull up, and totally annihilate everything that is not like incorrect, everything that hinders your plan. I believe, I believe, I believe in miracles. Come on. And so this morning we're wielding, come on, we're wielding our weapon of warfare. Come on, we're wielding our weapon of warfare. I believe, I don't know if Liz is still on. I believe that the Father is going to do great and mighty once your husband and family steps onto the ground of Puerto Rico. I believe, I literally believe that the revival is getting ready to break out. I believe that there are, come on, some movers and shakers that are on that island that the Father is saying, I am starting here. What looks like ruin, what looks like ruin, the Father says the latter will be greater than the former. And so we believe by faith, that the Spirit of the Lord is upon that island. We believe that the Spirit of the Lord is with this family. We believe that we are going to see, come on, the great and the mighty. Come on, Jeremiah 33:3. Come on, people who believe. If we call unto him, he will answer us and show us the great and the mighty. That word mighty means unattainable. The great and the unattainable. What does that mean? That word means that there was a fence. There was something blocking it. But when we call unto him, he answers us, and what was blocking the answer moves out of the way. So this morning we call unto him and he's answering us, and what is on the other side, what was fenced and what was covered, becomes uncovered. And so God, put in their hands what was once covered, put in their minds and their hearts what was once covered, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Rokanda basa. Rukutebe. And so God, we stand, hallelujah, in this 16th or 17th day of January this morning. And we are saying, we lift up a praise for 2020. We believe everything that you have already spoken and declared, even what we have not heard in our natural ear, but we have received in the prayer closet in our spirit, man. We understand that we commune with you in the place of the ninth season. And so Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for every download that you put in us overnight. I bless you, Father, for revelation, information, and demonstration that you imparted into your people in the overnight hours. I thank you, Father, that immediately when they were upon rising, that the revelation was already activated and the demonstration was activated according to Psalms 1. Verse 3, they are like the tree planted by the rivers of water. Mandio kotaya rokande, their leaves shall not wither. They give forth fruit in their season, and whatsoever they put their hands to shall prosper. That's called demonstration. That's called demonstration. We decree and declare that this is the year of the demonstrators. This is the year of the finishers. This is the year of putting our hands to a thing and seeing that thing come to pass according to scale, in the name and in the blood of Jesus. I decree and declare over your people this morning the released word of the Lord, that everything they put their hands to shall prosper. The word prosper, shalom. The word prosper, nothing missing and nothing lacking. That wind and nothing broken. That they put their hands upon a broke thing and it gets back together again. They put their hands again upon a lacking thing and it becomes filled. I thank you, Father, that in their hands is the released word of the Lord. I thank you, Father, that when they put their hands to a thing, the prophetic of the Lord is upon their fingertips. The prophetic of the Lord as upon their DNA, the prophetic of the Lord, Mandio Koshanda, and the creative power of God is in their hands, in the name and in the blood of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for every matter that is facing your people, every decision matter that is facing your people. I'm hearing the Lord say that there are some people on here and you are facing some decisions. You have to make a decision. The Father says, go ahead and make a decision, because you have to understand you are making the decision past your intellect. And the Father says that you will make the not the right decision, but the righteous decision. And so we put your mind at ease this morning. We put your mind at ease. You will not make the decision in angst and worry. And even the worry you have begin to feel, you've been feeling, that's actually causing more worry. That's stimulating more worry. It's stimulating more angst. Well, this morning we lock arms with you and we begin to chase away the worry. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, we say that the Father has not given you the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. And so, Father, in the name and in the blood of Jesus, thank you for the soundness of mind and love and power, my God, are coming upon your people in the name of Jesus. Pandabo, Ratandio Kosa, Randamoso, Mikatebe, Rukushiti. Thank you, God, that this is the year of the supernatural. This is the year where we see supernaturally you will cause your people to turn the corner. And so this morning in prayer, we decree and declare that the release word of heaven is shaking the people awake. We decree and declare that it is impossible, it is unlawful and improper for you to fall asleep on what God is doing. It is improper and it is unlawful for you to walk through like the walking dead. You have been made alive. You will not be lulled back to sleep. We decree and declare that lethargy and apathy is not going to come upon the people of God in this season in the name of Jesus. We decree and declare that your senses will not be dulled. Our senses will not be dulled by everything that looks like it's trying to pop off. An earthquake here and a volcano there and a war over there. We decree and declare that we keep our mind in the game. We keep the mind of Christ in the game. We keep our mouth speaking in the name of Jesus. Our measure of faith is active. According to Mark chapter 11, we have the faith of God. Come on. We have the faith of God. And he says to the disciples, if you have the faith of God, you can say to this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea. If we do not doubt or waver in our hearts. And so we decree and declare that the year of 2020 is the year that we do not waver and we do not doubt, but we pick up the faith of the Father. We put on the faith of the Father, the measure of faith given to all of us. And we stand flat-footed in the earth and we do not waver. We do not wither. We do not hesitate. But we speak to the mountain and say, God did not say you were supposed to be here. We say to the mountain, you're not supposed to be here. This is not where you are to be planted. This is not your place. You have no power here in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, this morning that you are shaking us. You are shaking us. You are not allowing us to be lulled back to sleep. You're not allowing us to be apathetic. You're not allowing us to be lazy and lethargic when it comes to the things of God. And so, God, we bless you. Hallelujah. Even for the fasting, whatever fasting the people are doing, we thank you, God, that you answer us in the fast. We bless you, God, that you answer us in the days of feasting. We are feasting upon what you did over the 90 days. We believe by faith, oh God, that constructs were built. We believe by faith, oh God, that you planted us in places, diverse places, and you are now releasing us to those diverse places. We believe, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I'm hearing the Lord say that over the next 3 months, wayward children are coming back home. Wayward children are coming back home. And so if your niece and your nephews, they've been out there and you don't know where they are. If your children have been out there and you don't know where they are, the Father says that this is the next 3 months is the season where the children will wake up in the pig pen and they will come to themselves. My God. They're going to come to themselves. And so, Father, in the name of Jesus, we protect their life with prayer and praise. We thank you, God, that you will get them back to us in one piece. You will get them back home. You will get them back to grandparents. You will get them back to mama and daddy. You will get them back to uncle and uncle, auntie and uncle. You will get them back to the people who've been praying for them in one piece with all of their limbs intact. We thank you, Father, that yes, they may need some deliverance, but that's okay. When the enemy has tried to literally take their life, you have preserved their life. The next 3 months, we release Akote. I see a scroll, like a piece of paper. I don't know if it's a scroll, but it's like a rolled up piece of paper, and it's just been dropped. And I see all these names. Mondabasaya, Rondeosha, Mendio Kandanamosa, Mendidoshe, Rundanosa. I see all these names. And so, Father, we thank you that these babies are coming back home. We thank you that these babies are coming back home. And listen, some of these aren't baby babies. Some of these old babies. We thank you, God, that these babies are coming back home. And so I hear the Father say, I hold fast to my word. My word is true. I watch over my word to perform it. If you train up a child in the way they should go when they're old, they shall not depart from it. And so this is the season, says the Father. Well, they have been trying to depart. They cannot depart. And so now they're coming on back home. Prepare the fatted calf, says God. Get the robe ready, says God. Prepare the ring, says God. Prepare the feast, says God. Because the babies are coming home in the name and in the blood of Jesus. Begin to praise me for the victory upon their life, says God. Begin to praise me for the victory in the name of Jesus. I'm hearing the Lord say that there are some children. There's some people who are out there and they are strung out on drugs. They are on drugs. The Father says, mandando cote, if you have the faith to believe it, that they are going to come to themselves, and literally this addiction is going to be broken off of them. Literally this addiction is going to be broken off of them. They're not going to have to do an AA, Al-Anon, 12 steps here and 12 steps there. The Father says, government and authority, mandioco, that's going to be broken off of them in the name and in the blood of Jesus. We cover them now. We thank you, God, for a dream in the night, according to Job 33, that you will say something that they will shake and quake, and they will cry out to you in the night watch. They will cry out to you in the overnight hours. Bring them back home in the name of Jesus. Bring them back on home in the name and in the blood of Jesus. We thank you for it now, God. Victory belongs to God. Hallelujah. Victory belongs to God. Victory was ours. Victory belongs to us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Manda soko nekanda mashete ronda mase. So the next 3 months, Father, we believe that we're going to see the testimony of heaven resting in the earth. We thank you, God, that none of your plans can be thwarted upon these little ones in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the covenant of mama and daddy. We thank you for the covenant of grandparents. Come on. We thank you for the covenant, God, of the people who came before us and said, as for me and my house, as for me and my lineage, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my lineage, we will serve the living God. As for me and my lineage, and so we will not be discouraged. We will not be discouraged by what we think we see in the name and in the blood of Jesus. Come on, guys. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so, Father, we are excited. We're excited about what we're getting ready to partake in. We're excited. We're excited. Masokota rotebesha. I hear the Lord say, open your mouth and ask. I'm hearing the Lord say, open your mouth and ask. And then once you ask, I'm hearing the Lord say, if you believe it, go ahead and begin to decree it. I hear the Lord say that there's going to be some things that happen really fast. There's going to be some things that happen really quick, really, really quick. Angela, I don't know if you're still on. I've been trying to pray for you the past couple of days, but life, things have been happening. I don't know if you're still on. Masodra Mashataya Rokota Ma Angela Mosodra Masoto Rukushanda Masuko Netebe Shaya Rokotaya Messi. I'm hearing the Lord say, I don't know if she's still on, praise the Lord. I'm hearing the Lord say, Get ready, because you're getting ready to enter into a season where you're going to have to make some decisions professionally. There's some things coming to you professionally that you didn't even see coming. Your name has been spoken into some rooms, says God, and they're getting ready to contact you. They're getting ready to contact you and just offer it to you. Offer it to you. So the Father says, now is the time. I've been showing you some things, bits and pieces here and there, and now is the time for you to make a decision. The Father says, make a decision according to faith. Make a decision according to faith, says God. Do not get like, I've got this and I've got that, because you're very, what's the word I'm looking for? You're very analytical and pragmatic. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You're very, very analytical and pragmatic when it comes to how you govern your life. And so the Father says, I can trust you in terms of government. Come on, Denise. I can trust you in terms of government, but now it's time for faith to step into the room. You've been able to put two things together. You've been able, by faith, with faith, because because you are a woman of faith, but there's also this undercurrent of being able to see your way through things. The Father says, and this is the season where I need you to close your eyes, and I just need you to see me. You're getting ready to meet my heartbeat for you, says God. This is a season, Angela, where God says, you're getting ready to see my heartbeat for you. You're getting ready to hear my heartbeat over your life. The Father says that you've been faithful to the assignment that I gave you, oh, so 6 years ago. You've been faithful to this assignment. You've been faithful. You have sacrificed to the point and places that you'll never say anything about. You just keep it moving and you keep it going, and you say some things to me sometimes in prayer, says God, but really you don't even talk about the depth of the sacrifice because sometimes you cannot even articulate it. Well, this thus saith the Lord this day over you. The Father says, this is the year, Angela, where I push you into another tax bracket. This is the year, Angela, where you look at this assignment and you have said, I want this for her and I want that for her. I want to do this and go there. I want this, that, and such and thus. The Father says, I have made note of every sigh of your heart, every tear that has fallen from your eyes in worship and in prayer. Not from regret, not from being overwhelmed, but just from simply praise and getting into my presence. The Father says, I have taken note of this, Angela. I have taken note of this, and so now I push it over the top. Call unto me, and I will show you the great and mighty that you know not of. And so the Father says that there are some intercessors that I've been praying for you. There are some people that have been praying for you, and the Father says that I'm answering you by answering them. And so, Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless you. I'm really seeing the summer months for you. They're getting ready to pop, pop, pop off like popcorn, says the Father. You're going to have to make some decisions. Do not back. Do not back away. Do not get weird and crazy. That's the only way I can explain it, says God. But just close your eyes and move in that, in what you see. Don't look at bills. Don't look at location. Don't look at all of these things. The Father says that he's releasing unto you your next place and your next steps. The Father says that he's releasing unto you new networks that's going to bring you into a new net worth, says the Father. And so, Father, we bless you for what you're doing in Angela's life. We thank you, Father, for the eye hasn't seen and the ear hasn't heard and hasn't entered into the heart of man what you have tailored for, you've made for those, what you've created for those who love you, but the Holy Spirit. And so the Holy Spirit has revealed unto us. Hallelujah. And so we decree and declare that the plan of you for your daughter cannot be thwarted. It cannot be hindered. It cannot be tampered with in the name and in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the year, guys. This is the year, says God. This is the year of new jobs, says God. This is the year of new jobs. The Father says, for some of you guys, I am giving you a second chance to sit in this school of this job where you didn't like the job. God says, I was trying to teach you something. I was trying to bring you this. These personalities are part of your potential. Handling these personalities are part of your potential and part of your purpose. The Father says, listen, lean in. The Father says, I extend to you a second chance to sit in the school again. The Father says, do not thwart this opportunity. The Father says, yes, it's never about pay, but the pay will be real good. It's not about pay. The Father says, this is a classroom for you. Some of you guys have said, well, I don't feel like I don't hold this degree and I don't hold that degree. How am I going to do such and thus and thus? And the Father says, well, I will put you in a classroom called a 40 hour. You get to pay for going to school. You get networks for going to school. The Father says, sit here and do not move until I tell you to move. And so we go back and we pick up every assignment that was aborted too quickly. We pick up every assignment that was aborted too quickly. Now, I know people like to tell you, if people treat you bad, if people do this, you need to go, you need your freedom, it's not worth it. Well, is that biblical? Is that God? Is that revelatory? Is that what God is saying? Because when I look at the scripture, it's never in the character of God for him to tell us to flee. Fleeing is not a thing in God. He gives us armor so that we can go into war. He gives us armor so that we are protected. Fleeing is not a thing. So I don't understand why this thing in the body of Christ is flee, run away, you ain't gotta take it. Baby, there are some things you gonna have to take. There are some things you're going to have to take because it's making you better. Could not Joseph have ran away from Potiphar? Could he have not in the night just ran away? Why did he stay at Potiphar? Why did he stay? Why did he just not run for the hills? Why did he hide out? Is that not what Moses did? Did not Moses run away? Moses ran away and got away. Why didn't Joseph run away? Why? Why didn't Joseph run away? Listen, if Joseph had ran away, he would have aborted. He would have aborted his destination. Potiphar was what put him in prison. Prison is what gave him the network of the baker and the butler. Don't look down. Don't thumb your nose at a network that looks like it's bound. You never know who they're connected to and how your destiny depends on these people you meet in prison. These people you meet in the low place. Why did he run when he was at Potiphar's? Why did he break out? Why didn't he? And so everything that we've aborted along the way, we ask for, we repent. We ask for forgiveness. We ask for the Father to extend a seat and the class of the Holy Ghost. Manda soko shanda raba sataro kusoto ramasiti shikur rebeki. So the Father is saying that there is a release. There is a release. And that's what's been the waiting on. Some people have some applications and some resumes that are out there and you've been wondering what's going on. The Father says, I need you to say yes to the process. They're abusing me. They're not thankful for my gifting. They're not thankful for who I am. They don't know who I am. They're not supposed to. They're not supposed to. The baker and the butler didn't know Joseph was going to be second in command. They just knew that he could interpret a dream. Come on. Come on. I got to be around people who see the gifts in me. They're not supposed to. It's not about the gifting in you. It's about you being integrous and having the character to sit in the process. To sit in the process, to take it. To pray for the people who abuse you and misuse you. Come on. Hallelujah. And so, Father, we thank you. For extending the classroom to us again in the name of Jesus. We thank you that we're a people who are fortified. We thank you for a people who are strong. We thank you that we don't flee in the face of adversity. Our strength is not small. Our strength is not small. Our strength is not small. We were built for this. We were built for this. We want to live. We want to grace every destination. You have grace for the spaces you occupy. You have grace for the space you occupy. You have grace for the space you occupy. Now use the grace. Learn how to pray with authority. Learn how to navigate with people. Learn how to be and look like the person of Jesus in the hard place. Every place we go, you can't flee from. Every hard place, you can't run from. You got to take it. You were built for this. You got places you gonna go. There's places connected to this. And you got to get there, says God, in the name of Jesus. And so, Father, we thank you for this absolutely wonderful, beautiful Friday. I bless you, Father, that your people are released to go into dancing. I bless you, God, that your people are getting ready to go out into the earth and they're getting ready to release the sound of heaven. The sound of heaven. And just because it's the weekend, it is not the weekend in heaven. Our expectation is still high. Our expectation is still full. And so, Father, we bless you. We praise you. We honor you. And it is in Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah and amen. Hallelujah. 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 So I love you. It already is a great day. Proclaim it, prophesy, and preach it. It's a great day. It's a great God day. It's a great God day. You feel good. You are energetic. Your cognitive space and ability has the grace and the glory of God on it. Amen. It's time to start back writing. It's time to start back creating. It's time to pull out some things and begin working on those things again, says the Father. Be purposeful with your weekend. Be purposeful with your weekend, says the Father. Be purposeful with your weekend. Masura Mashanda Roko Sataya. Runda Mosura Rebeko shall be purposeful. Be purposeful. Masoko Shiti. I'm hearing the Lord say, and then we're gonna get off. Because I gotta make breakfast for the middle schooler. I'm hearing the Lord say that there's some people on here, you will feel really, really lonely. You've been feeling really, really lonely and unprotected. I'm just gonna say how I see it. You feel unprotected. You just don't feel like you're protected in the earth. I'm hearing the Lord say that as of right now, He is breaking that off of you. You are protected. And so this spirit of loneliness that is trying to attack you and attack your life, we decree and declare that it's not your portion. We decree and declare that you feel full. You feel full. Masoto, with the people that are around. There are some people on here, you're single, and you've been praying for space of years, you know, for God to bring companionship. And for some reason, as the year has turned, you have been really feeling the lack of companionship for many. Listen, for many this year, people are getting married. Purpose relationships are coming together. Purpose relationships are coming together. Begin to ask God what the purpose is about when you come together with a spouse, because you guys are supposed to produce something. It is destinies colliding. It is purposes colliding. It is potential colliding. Begin to pray into that in the name and in the blood of Jesus. And so wherever you are, just begin to shake yourself. Do not let the spirit of loneliness attack your life. Don't let it inside of your borders. You are not lonely. You are in a season of solitude, and there's nothing lonely about solitude. Solitude is where, come on, solitude is where healing happens. Solitude is where downloads happen. Solitude is where, you know, when you're out there and you're dating and all these things, you're not in solitude anymore. And so the Father's got to get you in a place where He can give you download upon download, so you'll know some things, so that you won't get tricked and bamboozled by any counterfeits that try to come your way and steal you off of the road that the Father has planted you. The Father ain't going to let you be stole on. The Father is not going to let you be stole on in this season. And so He's downloading things to you, so you already know what it tastes like. It sounds like, you already know what it looks like. And so if it's a counterfeit, you understand the mark of the counterfeit. You understand the mark of the original. You understand the mark, come on, of the covenant. And so He's allowing you to see and say and deal with and handle the mark of the covenant. So when you get out there, you won't be tricked and bamboozled again in the name and in the blood of Jesus. And so there's some of you guys that, you know, that this season is very close to you and you're scared. You're feeling like you don't want to admit it because you really want it, but you're kind of scared because the last relationship was so bad, or you haven't had a relationship in a long time because the last one before it was so bad. Well, the Father says, this is not a season to be weary, and this is not a season to be scary. This is a season for you to put on your courage. This is a season for you to walk in your courage, because the purpose of God with these two lives coming together is going to build something that singularly we cannot build, but collectively as one, we absolutely can build. God is merging lineages. God is merging lineages. God is merging lineages. Masokota. And I don't care how old you are. I don't care how long it's been. God is not governed by time, age, time. That means nothing to God at all. So let's leave off from even praying that or even saying that. If that's you, don't even do that no more. Don't even do that. God has a way that He can bring this relationship to you. You may have been single for 20 years, 10 years, 15 years, whatever. And in 1 year, He can restore the time. In one year. A lot of times we'll look at our age and be like, well, I'll never be married for 50 years. God says, well, you don't need to be. God says that I will make your years like that of the 50 years. I will recover. I will recover what it looks like you lost in that time. You have not lost anything, says the Father. You have not lost anything. And so, Father, we thank You for the window in 2020 where marriages and relationships will be coming together. I decree and declare upon this wall that every marriage that comes together, a divorce will not come into their borders. I thank You, Father. That's number one. Number two, that counterfeits will not come into their borders in the name and in the blood of Jesus. I thank You, Father, that there will be ease of use handling the relationship. We are not going to be selfish. We will be selfless in the name of Jesus. I thank You, God, for every person who's going to assume the role of step parent. I thank You, God, that You built them to take care of these kids in the name and in the blood of Jesus. Purpose, 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 purpose. Ato kandeosa, rukandioko tebe, rukunda mashata, rukota letebe kosa, rutudura moshe. And so even for some of you, the Father is telling you to do your hair a little bit different. I need you to go ahead and do your hair different. The Father is telling you to go ahead and get some makeup. I need you to go and get some makeup. It's not about the hair and the makeup, but the Father is saying it's a new season, and I am giving you a makeup. I'm giving you a makeover. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm giving you a makeover. I'm making you look different. When we look different, we feel different. And so the Father is breaking off of you the humdrum, the ho-hum, and the ordinary. This is time for you to put on the extraordinary in the name of Jesus. And so we decree and declare that the makeover is an extraordinary look. The makeover is an extraordinary sound. The makeover is an extraordinary place in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And so, Father, we just receive it. We 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 receive it. So the Lord had given a prophetic word to somebody. I forget what it was, but who it was. But it was something like, for the years that things were taken, He was giving a makeover to make up for. The makeover was going to make up. It was going to make up. It was going to cover. Isn't that what makeup does? It covers, right? It covers. The Father says, I'm giving you a makeover to make up. Masukota, to make up what the cankerworm, the palmer worm, the swarming locust, and the eating locust. Come on, make up. Masukota, urokanda mashe, make up. God is making up time. Mosuraba, God is marking time. Rukutaba sukotebe she, rotonda. Don't look back over what you think you lost. Look forward. Look forward to what you have not even yet to step into. What is before you? The glory that is before you. The glory that is before you. The glory that is before you. Forget those things which are behind and press. Reach for in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So anyway, it's a beautiful day. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. We love you. Yes, we do. I love you. The prayer partners love you. We love you. We love you. So call three people and pray this over them. Hallelujah. Pray for them. Pray for your network. Pray for your friends. In Jesus' name. Y'all have